February scorcher. Hello everybody and welcome back to My Life in Taiwan. Now, this video has kindly been sponsored by my friends over at Cambly and this little guy here, hello, and they have an awesome app for learning English, more of which I'll come to later. But first, as you can see, we are deep in the middle of Lunar New Year here in Taiwan and lots of people going about their business here at the temple, people coming down, praying to their gods, ancestors, thanking them for previous fortune and of course inviting more good luck and fortune in the year of the pig. Now, in my previous video, I talked about 5 Taiwanese Lunar New Year traditions, but in this video, I'm coming from a slightly different angle, and I'm going to be talking about 5 Taiwanese Lunar New Year taboos, things that we should avoid doing here in Taiwan if we want to invite as much luck and good fortune as possible. And I'll also be talking about how we, as foreigners, can take advantage of this advice and avoid any cultural faux pas during this extra special time of year. So let's get straight into the first of 5 taboos we're going to talk about today. And for that, we'll be going back to those red envelopes that I mentioned in my previous video. Those red envelopes that are used for giving money between family members, maybe some friends, and for bosses to give to their employees. And what I neglected to mention about the amount of money in those envelopes is that it should never contain the number 4. And that's because the number 4 in Mandarin is very similar sounding to the word for death. And in Taiwanese, in the local Taiwanese dialect, it's actually exactly the same word. Therefore, you cannot give anybody a red envelope with a number 4 in it. But all other even numbers should be okay. Odd numbers are an absolute no-go. You cannot give somebody $500, $700 or $1,100 in a red envelope, as odd numbers are usually given in a white envelope to the grieving family at a funeral. Therefore, very taboo to use this number in a red envelope at Lunar New Year. So, as I said, be careful with the amount of money you put into someone's red envelope, as you don't really want what should be a kind-hearted gesture backfiring and causing somebody offense. Anyway, on to Lunar New Year taboo number 2, and that is one that I only just learned about this year, which is don't eat meat on New Year's Day morning. The reasons for this taboo are a little bit unclear, but from what I can gather and from what some friends have told me, it seems that giving up eating meat or becoming vegetarian is often used by people in Taiwan as a kind of promise to their god for some other fortune that they want to receive, or indeed as a thank you if a member of the family has been sick and becomes well again, then they will promise their god they will never eat meat again. Therefore, some families take this a little bit less seriously and just do it on New Year's Day morning. As a foreigner, it probably doesn't affect us too much, but it's probably best not to show up at your friend's house on New Year's Day morning with a double sausage and egg McMuffin meal from McDonald's. So before we get to the third taboo of Taiwanese Lunar New Year, let me reintroduce my little friend here and his app, Cambly. Now, I actually have already made a full video about this app, which you can see up here, but basically, if you are one of the many people that come to my channel in order to help improve your English, then Cambly and their thousands of qualified tutors can definitely also help you, especially when it comes to crossing that line of actually speaking out and talking to a foreigner. And what's even better is that all of my viewers can get 15 minutes absolutely free, one-to-one, face-to-face English tutoring from a qualified native speaker when you register using the code ALAN2018. So thanks to Cambly for their support of the channel, but let's get back to those five Lunar New Year taboos and on to number three, which is actually more applicable to married couples and states that as a married woman, you must not come home late to your mother-in-law's home on the second day of New Year. I can't tell you too much about this one, but I do know that when asking some local Taiwanese friends for some maybe different or strange taboos on Lunar New Year, this is one that a couple of them mentioned. As a married woman on it's the tradition to go back to your own parents' home, maybe have some lunch and relax with your own family, but it's very taboo to come home too late to your in-laws' home. Maybe the reasoning behind it is they will worry that you aren't going to come back, or it's disrespectful in some way. Maybe my awesome team, VVVIP, can use the comment section to enlighten me a little bit more on this particular taboo. But as a foreigner, this taboo doesn't really affect us too much, as generally our living situations are not what you'd call traditional. So on to number four in my list of Taiwanese Lunar New Year taboos, and that is owing money. In fact, owing money, lending or borrowing money, is strongly discouraged at this time of year, as it encourages debt and will probably lead to more debt in the coming year. Therefore, if you owe anybody money as a foreigner, get it paid before the holiday arrives. And if somebody owes you money, don't go asking for it over Lunar New Year. Leave it until a couple of months into the new year and avoid this cultural faux pas. So that brings me to number five in this list, and the final taboo of Lunar New Year here in Taiwan is don't do any washing. Especially don't wash your hair and don't do your laundry, don't wash your clothes. And closely related to this, don't sweep the floor of your house or business. Washing your hair or clothes, then of course you risk washing away any good luck, and sweeping the floor, maybe you will accidentally sweep out some good fortune that has already been bestowed upon your house or business. As a foreigner here, I see this as a perfect opportunity to put my feet up for a few days, watching Netflix, letting the laundry pile up, and doing as little as possible. Pretty much what I do most of the time anyway. But yes, that brings this video to an end. If you haven't already seen my previous video of the five customs that you must adhere to during Lunar New Year, then go check it out. And don't forget, like, share, subscribe. This time of year is all about sharing, right? And if you feel that in this video there are some taboos that I have missed out, then the comment section is there for you. Feel free to add anything that you don't do or you think people shouldn't do at this time of year to the comment section, and share and let people know what we do and don't do at this time of year here in Taiwan. Before I go, I want to say a big thanks to Cambly for their support of the channel, and also, I seldom say this, but I also want to say a very happy new year to my family, mum, dad, John and Lorna, grandmother, nanny I, back in England. I'm really missing you all so much. And of course, to my big boy William in South Africa, a very happy new year to you. Sorry that you have to go to school this week, big boy, while I'm on my holidays. But yes, you're coming here very soon in June, I think. And I'm sure we're gonna make lots of videos together. Happy New Year, big boy. Super duper miss you. But as for now, let me say once again, a very happy new year to all of my viewers, my team, VVVIP, subscribers, and your families. I really hope the year of the pig is as prosperous and beautiful as possible for you all. See you next time in my life in Taiwan. 新年快乐!